What's up, fellas? I'm Russ's Corpse. I'll be your operator today, and we are starting Series 3 of Duskers. Now, Series 2 ended in a very terrible tragedy that was completely and totally 100% not my fault. But hopefully this will be a little better. Now, we learned a few things. We decided that, or I guess. I say we because, remember, I make my videos as if you guys are just kind of hanging out next to me playing. You know, we're bullshitting and whatnot. But I decided that there are a couple different things that I'm going to try in regards to, like, modules and stuff. But look at over here. I've already taken the liberty of switching my drones around. But I kind of screwed up here. Hold on. There we go. Get that guy over there. There we go. Alright, so Cutter being the 130 guy, pretty damn good. So we're going to get right into, I guess, the Sugriva here, which is a private, a decently large private, because it's an A, with only one infestation type. Now, we don't have any way to get rid of infestations other than venting, because I don't have an interface, and I'm hoping to find an interface super quick. We do also have the two theories that we're working toward, the Super Predator and the pandemic. So hopefully, because remember, that all like carries over, so hopefully we'll be able to get some good headway on those. I still don't exactly know what to look for the pandemic, but I have to check out military vessels for the Super Predator. So we've got a terminal right off the bat, and I can check. Well, let's close door 13 right up. Oh, hello. Here's the deal. I don't know if he's in room 11 or room 12, so we're going to flank both of those because we know an enemy is there. Somebody was moving back and forth between those two. That's why the door wouldn't close. So that could be a problem. But the first thing we're going to do is we're going to check out room 4. Let's close door 21. I don't really need to drop a sensor just yet, so we're just gonna stealth up and check it out. Alright, we got ship defenses in here. That is good. I am gonna drop a sensor in the ship defenses room. Oh, drop it right there. Because if I find an interface, that's what we're gonna be using. So let's check out room 6. No whammies? Alright, I believe we're good here. And I gotta do a sweep because I don't have a scan module. So I just want to make sure that I'm picking up everything. Scrap and whatnot. We are scrapless so far. There was no scrap in any of these rooms. I'm gonna check 8 before I get down to 5 because 5 is big enough that I think they may have, you know, put something there. Oh, hello. Alright. Let's go. No whammies. We got fuel. Fuel's good. And no whammies. Let's gather up that fuel then. Fuel's gonna be very important. Obviously, as you guys know, for getting around. It's unfortunate that I didn't get jump fuel there. Alright, so let's pop close D6. Now we're finally gonna check our room 5. And if room 5 is balls, I'm gonna try and herd it into room 8. So let's put a sensor in here. Let's see what we can find. Because roommate is effectively done. Anything? Okay, we do have a downed drone, or a destroyed drone. But room 5 is clear. Excellent. Close door 17. Swap. Oh, we have a teleport. Teleport's going to be good. Teleport. I don't know what to remove to keep teleport, though. So let's just go give it to Wraith for now. Because at least he'll be able to teleport in and tow something. But teleport is part of one of my new strategies. What I'm going to be doing is upgrading teleport. And being able to teleport sensors into specific rooms. Which is going to be really good. So let's close that bad boy. All right. Moving on. Thank you, Lizard. Too bad that you are not usable. Now, room 5 is not one of the rooms that I am prepared to herd something in to keep it in there. All right, we've got a vent. But I'm not sure. Okay, that's empty. Let's get out of here. We don't know what the infestation type is. It very well could be a swarm. So you know what? I'm going to put a sensor in room 7. And if that pops, then we know it's a swarm on the ship. So let's do that. Because I'm not going to be moving anything into that room. So if it pops, that means a swarm spawned in that vent. And that means that there is a swarm somewhere else on the ship. You guys have taught me that. To look out for that. Now, clearly there's something... I believe it's probably room 10, guys. So let's go check room 11. Because a sound is coming from room 5... you know, in room 5 I can hear the sound, so it's probably coming from either 10 or 9. So I think whatever was in door 13's way when I tried to close it probably moved down into 10. So let's check this. Nope. It is there. Well, I am not prepared to unflag room 10 just yet. So let's go check it. I mean, it really sounds like something's in there. Oh, wait. That sounds coming back from the way I came, which doesn't make any sense. I don't know if the sound design or like works with my headset or not, but let's go ahead and get into room 9 and check it out. Room 9 seems to be clear. Just gonna check it for scrap and whatnot. Got a ship upgrade. What are you? A long-range scanner. I do want that. I do want that. I've actually never found one of those before. And I want it. So let's get 3 over there. Yeah. Alright. So we're gonna pick up that long-range scanner. I believe what that does is shows me more systems on the galaxy map. Oh, really? You're just not gonna go around Cutter? Alright, as soon as we get out of Cutter's way, we'll just nav 3 or 1 and close doors behind him. Or at least this door. Okay. Did we check room 10? I don't think we checked room 10. Did we check room 10? No, because it's dotted line, so I didn't even go in. So we know there's an enemy in room 11. So we're checking room 10. My cat is freaking out. So, well, there's nothing I can really do about that now because I don't, you know, shit happens on this ship. Well, I'll tell you what. I am going to pause it, and I'll go deal with that. Be right back. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and we are about to check room 10. I'm ready. Door 14. Room 10 definitely has a bad guy, but it's also got scrap. That sucks. Because I don't have a way to get rid of these yet. So I guess... that's weird, then. I guess they were just trading rooms at the time. But what I can do is herd that guy into room 9, which is what I'm... God damn it, what I'm going to do. So let's put a sensor way over here so he has to come all the way into the room to shoot it. Because that is the type of enemies these are. And let's do that. Alright, let's open door 14. And wait. Come on, buddy. Now, this ship does have 2 upgrade slots, which is good. But it's got less scrap capacity than my ship. So we will not be commandeering it. Alright. I don't know if he's actually going to attack it. Yep, he's attacking it now. Okay. Stealth up, just to be sure. Swing on in here. We do have 1 piece of scrap. I'm surprised he got through that. Alright, cool. Let's gather all. We're going to close door 7. And now we can check out 13 and 12. And then after I check out 13... Oh, are you going to be able to get through that, dude? Come on, Cutter. There we go. After I check 13, I will herd whatever is in 11 into 13 and check 11, and then we'll be done. But first, I'm going to check 12. Which is right meow. No whammies? Excellent. I guess more than two enemies does seem kind of weird for the first ship. But we're good there. So now we can just check room 13, and then we'll have to like herd the dude in there. Just waiting on the stealth. Alright. What you got for me in here? It is clear. Oh. No scrap though, man. They're not doing me any favors with the scrap. Alright, let's put a sensor over here. There's only one airlock, right? Yeah, so I can't actually blow these guys out of the airlock, even if I wanted to come into this ship. Alright, here we go. Get your ass in there, buddy. Get out of my room. I need it. There we go. Alright, so we can unflag room 10. And, as usual, not unflagging room 11 until I actually get in there and check it. Because of the whole crazy snafu from series 2 when I lost 2 drones to a swarm. Let's get in here. It is now clear and also pointless. So, time to go. Whole place has been checked. Let's open door 7. And end. Alright. So we got through our first ship of series 3. It was an A, so that's pretty cool because we got a lot of rooms covered. Unfortunately, didn't get a whole lot of scrap. Although we did get a teleport, which is going to come in very, very handy. Especially if I have enough scrap to upgrade it. But first thing we're going to do, put that long-range scanner on there. Oh man, it's almost busted too. Look at that. Shows everything. Excellent. Okay, let's see. I have 5 scrap. Teleport droppable items. Bam. Done. All right. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put sensor on Wraith. There we go. Now he is a sensor teleporting motherfucker. Okay, so now we need to figure out which way we want to go. I'm not going to use that Stargate at all, because going into another galaxy right off the bat, terrible, terrible idea. We do have a salvage C here with only one infestation type. We have a military. Oh, I want to go to this one because I think that it would be a good idea to commandeer this ship. Unfortunately, I don't have a way to get rid of things other than venting them, but let's swing over here and check this one out. Plus, I need military for one of the theories. Aha! Got one! Due to the elevated security levels, communications and reports classified as level 2 or higher have been removed from all military vessels. Upon something accessed, these messages must now be requested from archives aboard secure military outposts. Oh. Search military outposts. So I'm going to need to find a transporter while being on a military ship. So that is actually going to be a somewhat difficult one, but let's go ahead and begin. All right, we got power, we got scrap, we got a ship upgrade, we got a terminal. Did I get this little corner back here? Yeah, all right. Any more scrap? No? Okay. Let's go ahead and get that other one before we move on. Sweet swerve, Cutter. Alright, and we're checking room 4. This generator does not power for shit. Let's close that. Alright, there's only one infestation type. So it might be another easy one. Depending on what the hell was that? The fuck is that noise? I don't know, but let's get to it. Alright, so we're switching to three. We're going to sensor and then teleport sensor R5. Okay. Room 5 is fine. So, now what I can do is teleport to room 5 because room 5 is fine. So let's do that. I really should be doing this on the gather guy though, to be honest. I guess it doesn't matter because now that I know room five is clear, I can open 6 and have him go in. I think that is empty. Yeah, it definitely is. All right, so let's teleport sensor R6. Room 6 is also fine. I can just open. I don't need to teleport into room 6 for that one, but let's go do it. Yeah. Alright, we got some defenses in here. And I'll just swing by with Cutter and pick all the stuff up. So I kind of want to leave a sensor in this room, but I guess it's not that big of a deal. So let's teleport sensor to R2. Okay. There is evil in there. That is not good. But since we don't have an idea of what the other rooms are, we actually have to go back to manually searching. So this works way better with a ship surveyor. But we know that whatever is in room 2 is organic because it's not shooting the sensor. So let's flag room 2. Even though we have a sensor in there, let's go ahead and flag it. And then we're going to teleport to room 1 and stay there for a second. We're going to get busy doing what we're supposed to be doing here, and that's searching. Unfortunately, I don't have a reroute power or anything either. That kind of sucks, but stealth up, open door 11, go check it out. Door 11 is fine, and it has power. It's good to know. Huh. All right. Nav 2 to R7. Let's get Cutter out of the way. And have him pop that generator on so we can check room 8. Excellent, we can still check it from room 3. Nope, damn it. Okay, so I'm going to close airlock 1 just in case something does get out. We'll see. I'm gonna do it from room 4 actually. Yeah, it's a better idea, so I don't have to worry about that. So let's go open airlock 1 back up. We'll do it from this room so that I don't have to worry about an enemy getting into room 3 and making my life difficult. To be honest, I can teleport a sensor in there. Okay, there is evil in room 8. That is balls. So I think what we're going to do is herd whatever is in room 8 into room 4. So let's get Cutter out of room 4. Well, we'll do that in a second. When we're ready to check stuff out there, we'll do that. But we need to check whatever's behind door 7 here. Which is fuel and scrap. And we're good here. Alright, excellent. Okay, we're doing okay here. The teleport sensor thing makes things a little bit more safe. We've only got one more room, but I need to power it. Unfortunately, the only way to power it is room 2. And that sucks. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a sensor in room 9. And then I'm going to try and herd it into room 9 from room 2. Which means that I'm going to have to go... I believe the room 3 generator powers room 2, but I'm not sure. I don't remember. So let's just get out of there. Whoa. Oh, okay. That could have been serious. And what we're going to do is we're going to teleport a sensor into room 9. Okay. Now we need to nav 2 back to room 3 and generator that bitch. I could get whatever is in room 8 into room 6 and vent. Oh, I can't. I can't power, or I can't open door 14. That's going to be a problem. There's a busted drone in there too, which means it could have an interface, which would make dealing whatever's in room 8 easy. So let's figure this out. I was unable to open 14 even with the generator in 7. So I think what I might need to do is herd room 2 into room 3. So let's or 7. Let's get back over there and power that and see which doors it actually powers again. Okay, that's not all that great, to be honest. Fuck, what am I going to do here? I need to get into room 2. I mean, I could go in it with the stealth. That doesn't really help. And I don't know what's in room 8. I mean, there very well could be a drone in there with interface, but that I believe that is wishful thinking. I really need an interface. I mean, even an interface wouldn't help me with room 2, though. I need to get the guy in room 2 somewhere else. The only way I can power door 9 is from room 3, so that is not going to work. What was in that ship upgrade? Ship surveyor. Oh, I need this ship so bad. A long range scan, or the ship surveyor with the teleport business would be so great. What is the scrap on this? 59. I really need this ship. That's going to be a problem. I need to get whatever's in room 2 out of room 2. But I need to power room 3 to do that. Unfortunately, okay, so room 3 powering will get me access to door 9, which does not help. But neither of those will get me access to door 14. That is the problem. Okay, all right, I think I got it. It's gonna take some doing, though. Let's put a sensor here. And then we will put a sensor here. Get Wraith back in here and close the door. Okay. If I were to put teleport on Wyvern, have him power room 3, quickly open door 9, and then teleport to room 7, then I could have door 9 and door 13 open. Wait until that guy finally wanders into room 4 and then close 13. We're going to try that, guys. So I need to get Cutter somewhere safe. I mean, on the ship would work. But, yeah, let's do that. And then what I need to do is get Wraith over to room 7. And we're gonna... What is going on? Door 14. That'll be fine. I'm not worried about that. I'm worried about door 9 and door 13. So, let's swap, and let's put that teleport right meow. And then we gotta get Wraith back onto the ship. Okay, this definitely will work. I am very confident that this will work. Okay, so let's close door 11, just in case some bullshit happens. And we're gonna switch the two. Teleport. R3. Generator. We're going to close D6. Okay, and then we're going to open door 9 and then teleport R7. Please, please, please do it. Thank you. Okay. So now we wait. All right, we got it. Excellent. Excellent. Okay. So, still, okay. Teleport room 3. Generator. And we'll just leave teleport on him for now. And we'll go see what the hell is going on in this room. Yeah, I forgot that I had teleported one in there. Okay, so what do you have, sir? Pry and gather. Well, pry is decent. Gather is good as a backup, but it is not what I wanted. So after this ship is done, we're going to have to do drone maintenance to get stuff back on the drones they're supposed to be on. But let's pick this stuff up and get you back onto the ship. Now we need to get 2 to R2. Flag R4. Flag R2. Room 4 and room 8 are balls. Let's power this up. Okay. So here's what we need to do. We need to get the teleport back on Wraith. So he can sensor. I know this is kind of a waste of sensor resources, but I'm being extra careful. Because, you know, I don't want to lose anything right off the bat. It would be a very terrible run if I managed to completely screw up right at the beginning. Teleport. Sensor R10. And R10 is clear. Let's go do it. Door 15. Nothing. Alright, so here's the deal. I need to commandeer this ship. Which means that I need these assholes into a room that I can vent. I'm afraid to vent room 3 because of the ship survey. The ship survey module. I don't want to lose that. Which means that I need to get them into room 6. So, easy enough, but going to take a while. Let's teleport that sensor to room 5. And then room 6. We use so many sensors on this, but I think it's okay. So now I need to get 2 back into room 2. Or R3. Power that so I can open door 6. Hit that generator. I need to get Cutter out of here so I can close door 9 as well. So let's get Cutter back on the ship because he is essentially done until we can get these guys out of here. So now I need to close door 9. Open door 6. Open door 11. And then get over there. And hopefully I'll still be able to open door 13 and 12. Because those are the key doors. I can't open door 10 from here? What the f... Okay, alright. Well, that's fine. We'll just go and open door 10. Yeah. Open door 10. Now what we're going to need to do is, behind these enemies, close door 6, because when I vent it, I don't want it to vent all the way to room 3, which I think happens. So let's close door 11. I cannot close door 6 from here. What in the fuck? I can't even close door 10. Oh my god, this is going to be a pain in the ass. This is going to be a big pain in the ass. But I'm going to get it done. Just hold on for a second. Do I have anything? Shit. Does the second... Does room 3's generator power anything toward that airlock? I don't think so. Let's check. It's very important to note what that powers. Okay, it does, but it doesn't power door 4 or door 5. So I was thinking that I could pry open doors that I don't need, but this is... Okay, I need to put teleport on 2. This'll work. This'll work, guys. Teleport is such a great module for this kind of stuff. Alright, I got this. It's gonna be no problem. So what we're gonna do is... Oh, wait. What I'm going to do, let's generate, is... Oh, my cat. Okay, hold on. Be right back. All right, we're back. So this is the deal. This is what I'm thinking. That's fine. I don't care about drone 1 right now. If I can get them into room 5 and then teleport into 3, generator, and close D6 real quick... Might have a chance. Fuck, this is going to be crazy. Alright, let's try it. Unfortunately, we have to get them both in there. Alright, guys, get out. This might take a little bit because I'm going to wait for the very best opportunity. Okay, so they're both in room 3 now. As soon as room 3 is clear, we're going to teleport R3 gen D6. Fuck. Okay, I mean that's great and all, but you're not doing what you need to do. Come on. Room 3, get out. Ah, come on. Okay, this is why it's going to take a while. Oh! Oh my god! I didn't think it was going to work because it didn't D6 like I told it to. Oh, because it wasn't powered. Okay, so now we're going to teleport back to room 7. Generator. Oh. Fuck. I can't close door 10. How does one close door 10? How did I even get door 10 open? Port R3. Okay. As soon as they're in room 6, close that door. I gotta get them both in there, though. Close. Oh! Beautiful! Later, bitches. Commandeer this shit. What's the problem? Oh, I haven't searched room 4 and 8. Oh shit. 6 and 5. Ah, don't care. Alright, let's go. Maybe we can commandeer this shit before that happens and not have to worry about it anyway. This is room 4. Nothing. Can I get into room 8? Yes. Excellent. You just have to be creative when you don't have all the good stuff, you know? Alright. Yeah, I know. And done. Excellent. Okay. So we have now a ship scanner, which is going to... like help immensely with the teleporting sensors around, and we got a higher scrap capacity. I think we're doing good, ladies and gentlemen. So first of all, okay, we've already got our stuff on. Didn't think that I'd be able to take that off because it was, you know, bolted on, but we need to get this stuff back together with where it goes. Okay, looking good. I don't need to worry about reloading sensors until it gets down to about 25. But let's go ahead and look at what scrap we have. We still only have 5 scrap. Because I used 3 to upgrade the teleport. Okay, so we're still doing good. Unfortunately, guys, that is all the time I've got today. I know that I've been putting out hour-long episodes recently. But today, well, let's check this first. The Super Predator. Yeah, so I have to go to a military outpost. Unfortunately, I don't have a lot of time to record today. That's the problem. So, rest assured, tomorrow's episode will be back to the hour long, or 45 minutes to an hour. But today, because I didn't get a video yesterday, I really didn't have enough time to record today either. But because I didn't do a video yesterday, I wanted to make sure that I got one out for you guys. In any case, if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you want to see more videos of Duskers or any of the other videos that I've done, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you have anything to say, throw it down in the comments or hit me up at Restless Corpse on Twitter. That is at Restless Corpse, one word. Also, I do have to say that we are fast approaching 1,000 subscribers, and I know that is largely due to... not only my Duskers viewers, but my Elite Dangerous viewers as well. I just want to throw out a big thank you. If it keeps going at the rate that it's going, to be honest, either the day this goes out, which is tomorrow for me, or the next day, we'll probably be at 1,000. It's really awesome. I haven't really planned anything for a 1,000 subscriber special because I didn't think it was coming this fast. But you guys are really knocking it out. Remember, if you want to help the channel grow, commenting, liking, and sharing the video, you know what, link it to your friends and whatnot. That really helps YouTube, gets its dick hard for things like that. and it really helps out a channel. But you guys have been doing awesome, and I really appreciate it. I just wanted to say thank you. Anyway, I was Rusty's Corpse. I was your operator today. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I appreciate each and every one of you, and I'll see you guys in the next video.